Hello, I'm Robin Worley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today I'm looking at using the Nik Collection as a standalone photo editor rather than as a plugin. It's something I've covered in the past, but not in detail. So in this video, I'll be explaining how to find the Nik Collection files you need to launch the applications. I'll also be sharing some helpful tips to make this easier on a Mac and Windows PC because it isn't intuitive. First though, we need to look at what happens when you install the Nik Collection to your computer. Now currently I'm on a Mac computer and I've already downloaded and started the Nik Collection installer. When you run the installer, it allows you to choose where the Nik Collection is installed and it walks you through some of the steps. The first point I want to discuss is the compatible host screen. On a Windows PC this actually runs a little later in the installation process. But what it shows are the compatible host applications the installer has detected on my computer. These are the applications the Nik Collection will install itself to. You can also use these plus and minus buttons at the bottom to add other applications like Affinity Photo or even remove identified applications from the list. But what's important to understand is that the Nik Collection doesn't just install itself once, because these different applications may need different types of files to run Nik. For example, Photoshop will need the Photoshop plugin files, where Lightroom and Photolab will probably need the executable files. What's also important about this is that these different files are installed to different locations on your computer. With Photoshop, as I covered in a previous plugin tutorial, there are special folder locations that need to be used. If you want to know more about the plugin locations, I'll include a link to more information in the YouTube video details. Now when it comes to the Nik application files or executables, these shouldn't be installed to the same location as the plugins. Of course, the Nik installer takes care of a lot of this for you and installs the plugins to the correct locations. Now when I click the Continue button, I see another screen which allows me to choose where the Nik application files are installed. If you're using a Windows PC, you actually reach this screen before the one we've just looked at. In this screen, I can see there's a default location the Nik installer wants to use. On a Mac, it's the Nik Collection folder, which is created in the Applications folder. If this were a Windows PC, it would be a folder in the Program Files directory, which is usually on your C drive. We can, of course, change these locations to use different custom locations. This is important because if we want to use the Nik Collection standalone, we need to know where the application files are installed. If you've used the default folder locations when you installed the Nik Collection, you should be able to find these quite easily. I'll include the default locations in the YouTube video information. But if you change the default location folders at all, or you couldn't find the files, you need to search for them. On a Mac, you can use the search feature in the Mac Finder. If you're using a Windows PC, you can use a similar search feature in the Windows File Explorer. What you need to search for is one of the Nik Collection application files, because when you find one of them, you'll find the others. I'd recommend searching for something like Vivaza 2 because it's a short file name that's easy to enter. I'd also recommend including the file extension in the search because just searching on Vivaza 2 will turn up a few results that you don't need. If you're searching on a Mac, look for vivaza2.app. But if you're using a Windows PC, you need to be looking for vivaza2.exe, which is the Windows executable file. This finds Vivaza on my hard drive and all the other Nik applications are in the same folder. On a Windows PC, it's slightly different as the applications are split into separate folders in a Nik Collection folder. When you locate the application files, check you have the right type of file. You can do this by double-clicking on the file to see if the Nik application launches. If it does, you've got the right file. Now notice there's something odd about this application. There isn't an image open for editing, but more importantly, there isn't a menu or any other way to open an image. One method to open an image that works on both a Mac and Windows PC is to drag and drop the image file you want to edit using your mouse. But you can't just drop the file onto the open application because that doesn't work. Instead, you need to drop the image file onto the application files themselves in the Mac Finder or Windows Explorer. This launches the Nik application and opens the file. Now I can edit the image, and when I'm done, I'll click the OK button. This saves my adjustments back to the image file. Now on a Mac, there are a couple of things you can try that makes this easier. When you open a Nik application, its icon appears in the dock bar along the bottom of the screen. Now, if I drag and drop an image onto that icon, it opens it for editing. Secondly, if you have enough space in your dock bar, you can always add the Nik applications that you want to use there as icons. You can then drag and drop the image file onto that icon to open it for editing. With Windows, there's a taskbar along the bottom of the screen, but it works slightly different to the dock. I can still use this to add a Nik application that I want to use, and I can also use that icon to open the application. But if I drop an image file onto the icon, it gets added to the list as an item. I then need to open that item in the list to edit it. After I've finished editing, I then need to remove it from the taskbar, or the taskbar is going to fill up very quickly. I find a better alternative is to create a shortcut on the computer desktop. I can do this by right-clicking on the application file in the Windows File Explorer. In the pop-up menu, I can choose the Create Shortcut option, and then select to add this to the desktop. Now I can drag and drop my image file onto the shortcut icon to open it for editing. That's the basics of how to open an image for editing using only the Nik Collection, but there are a couple more points that I want to share. The first is that you need to be editing a Nik-compatible image file for this to work. That means the image needs to be a JPEG file or a TIFF file in either the 8 or 16-bit format. This is important because Nik needs to be able to save your changes back to the file when you click the OK button. It is possible that you'll find some file types like RAW files where the Nik editor actually loads up the image, but because the RAW file isn't a compatible format, it can't save the changes. The other important point is that I recommend using the TIFF file format rather than JPEG. This allows you to edit a 16-bit file rather than an 8-bit file, which withstands the editing better. But it also allows you to take advantage of the non-destructive workflow introduced in the Nik Collection 3. When you open a TIFF file in the Nik Collection 3, you see this message and an option to use the non-destructive editing. If I apply and then save some changes, those settings are saved inside the TIFF file. Then when I reopen the TIFF file, my filters and any control points I added are still there. This feature was first introduced in the Nik Collection 3, so if you're using an earlier version of the Nik Collection, you won't have access to it. Now there is one final feature that I want to talk about and share with you. I'm not quite sure when it was introduced, but it certainly wasn't in any of the early versions of the Nik Collection. If I launch one of the Nik Collection applications as a standalone editor, I now have a menu in the Mac. And in that menu, I have a File Open option, and I can use this to open new files for editing. The Windows version also has something similar, and rather than a menu, it now has an Open button which appears in the top left of the interface, and these appear whenever I'm running the Nik Collection standalone. So if you have the latest version of the Nik Collection, which at the moment is version 3, check to see if you have these options available to you. I hope that you've found today's video helpful and interesting. If you have, please take a moment just to share it with others. I'm Robin Worley, you've been watching LensCraft, I'll see you soon for another video.